So good morning everyone. So in the previous class we had seen about the class A amplifier, the classification of amplifiers, and we had seen about the class A amplifier. Now we'll go for the class B amplifier. So we know that in class B amplifier, your class B amplifier is going to have the Q point to be on the cutoff region. So when I'm going to plot, and that is when I'm going to have in the characteristic curve IC versus VCE, I'm going to plot the DC load line, and the Q point is going to be chosen at the cutoff point there. So when it is going to be chosen at the cutoff point, we can see that only your transistor or your system or your transistor is going to conduct for only 1/2 of the cycle. That means for class B amplifier, your conduction is going to be for 180 degrees only there. So in that case, I'll be getting only 1/2 of the output waveform. So our requirement is to get the full sine waveform. So in order to get the full sine waveform, what we are going to do is, we are going to use your class B amplifier as a push-pull amplifier. So where this push-pull amplifier is going to consist of a complementary pair of transistors. So where a transistor, an NPN transistor and a PNP transistor, it is going to be connected in such a way that it cannot conduct simultaneously. So now if I am going to see the operation of the circuit, your operation of the circuit is going to be during the positive half cycle. So I am going to have during the positive cycle of the input signal. So this is your VI. So during the positive portion of the input signal, the Q1 transistor is going to conduct. When Q1 transistor conducts, your switch is going to be, this NPN transistor is going to be in the on state. So when it is going to be in the on state, this transistor is going to act like a closed switch, and you are going to have the current to be flowing like this to your load resistance RL. So your NPN transistor is going to conduct. So when VI is going to be positive, your Q1 transistor is going to conduct. And when Q1 transistor conducts, this transistor acts as a closed switch, and your VCC is going to be at the output. Or this is going to act as an emitter follower. So emitter follower is your VI, your output is nothing but VI minus the voltage at this point is going to be your VBE voltage. So VBE N voltage is going to be the voltage at this point. So when this voltage is going to be there, your V out is nothing but VI minus VBEN minus V naught. That means V naught is equal to VI minus VBEN. So here you are going to get an output waveform during the positive half cycle. So during your positive half cycle, I'm going to get the output waveform to be present there. And next is, I'm going to consider the negative cycle. So at that time, if I'm going to see your QP transistor, the transistor QP is going to be in the cutoff region. When it is going to be in the cutoff, your transistor will not conduct, and you are going to have this current to be flowing like this, and you are going to have your output voltage to be IL into RL. So here in this case, during a negative cycle, what happens is your VI is going to, here your Q1 transistor will not conduct. So when a Q1 transistor doesn't conduct, your QP transistor conducts. When your QP transistor conducts, your circuit is going to be in the on state. When it is going to be in the on state, your current starts flowing in this direction to your ground terminal. So here in this case, your current is going to flow like this. So the circuit is going to get completed like this. The switch is going to be closed, and because of this VI negative cycle, your switch is going to be closed and you are going to get it there. So now the output voltage is going to be the reverse of it. That is your VI. So this is your PNP transistor. So PN. So this is going to be plus. This is going to be minus. So here in this case, this voltage is going to be your base emitter B voltage there. So VI. This is a negative. So minus VI plus VB minus V naught is equal to 0. That means V naught is equal to VI plus minus VEB is going to be the output. And you see that the output across the resistance RL is going to be in the opposite direction. That means I'm going to get the output during your negative cycle. So this is going to be my output voltage. So here in this case, this is your output voltage. This is going to be your time period T. So here we are going to see that it is a complementary pair of transistor where we are going to have NPN transistor and a PNP transistor, which is going to be connected in such a way that both the transistors will not conduct at the same time. Now we are going to assume that your V input is going to be positive. So input is going to be positive means your Q1 transistor is going to conduct. So when Q1 transistor conducts, your current starts, your output is of the Q1 is going to act as an emitter follower, and we are going to have the output current to be flowing through your RL resistor. So the Q1 will act like a closed switch, and from here the current will start flowing. So that means that this transistor will conduct and your current will start flowing from this here like this. So when it flows, you are going to have your output to be V0 is equivalent to VCC minus VCE1 saturation, VCEN saturation, or in other terms if you tell, your V0 is nothing but V1 minus VBEN. That is going to be the output voltage there. So you are going to get the output current. So the load resistance, so V0 is equivalent to IL into RL, so you are going to get the positive voltage. During the negative half cycle, your Q1 transistor doesn't conduct, but QP transistor conducts. When this transistor conducts, this circuit is going to act like a closed switch and current is going to flow in this direction and the circuit current is going to complete. So we can see that your output is nothing but your minus VI plus VEB minus V0 is equal to 0. So that means V0 is equal to minus VE1 plus VEB is equal VEBP is equal to V0. So your current is in the opposite direction. So my output is nothing but negative. So for one full cycle, I'm going to get the output to be in full cycle there. So we can see that your class B output says, even though the Q point is going to be located at the cutoff point, my conduction, because of using a complementary pair of transistors, I can get an output for full cycle there. So here this is your complement class B output stage amplifier. So here that is what we have explained here. So when the input voltage is going to be 0, both the transistors are going to be cut off and the output voltage is going to be 0. So next, first, there is a first condition. Input voltage is 0, both the transistors are cut off and the output voltage is 0. As VI goes positive, that is the minimum voltage that is required for a transistor to conduct, for a PN junction to conduct, should be either 0.3 volts or 0.7 volts. So suppose if it is going to be a silicon transistor, then it should be 0.7 volts there. So if VI goes positive and exceeds about 0.5 volts, then Q1 is going to conduct and it's going to operate as an emitter follower. So in this case, V0 follows VI. So V0 is nothing but VI minus VBEN, and Q1 supplies the load current there. Next is during VI positive, the emitter base junction of QP will be reverse biased. So when it is going to be reverse biased by the VBE of Q1, which is approximately 0.7 volts, the QP will be cut off there. So that is during the positive cycle, Q1 conducts and it is going to act as an emitter follower. V0 will follow the VI and the QP will be in the reverse biased and QP will be in the cutoff region there. Next is if the input goes negative. So if the input goes negative by more than 0.5 volts, then QP turns on and acts as an emitter follower. V0 follows VI, that is V0 is equivalent to VI plus VBEP. So QP supplies the load current and Q1 will be cut off. So here in this case, the transistors are going to be biased at zero current and it is going to conduct only when the signal is going to be present. So here circuit is going to operate in a push-pull fashion. Q1 pushes the current into the load, that is it sources the current into the load when VI is positive, and QP pulls the current from the load or sinks the current from the load when the VI is negative. So here is this, we say that your class B amplifier, the other name for class B amplifier is your push-pull amplifier there. So push-pull amplifier, why we say it as push-pull amplifier is when VI is positive, Q1 is going to push, the NPN transistor is going to push the current into the load or source the current into the load, and when VI is negative, QP is going to pull the current from the load or sinks the current from the load when VI is negative. So next is we are going to see the transfer characteristics. So transfer characteristics is, so here we see that there is going to be a range of VI which is going to be centered around 0 when both the transistors are cut off. When both the transistors are cut off is, for an NPN transistor to conduct, the minimum base emitter junction should be 0.7 volts. So in that case, if my input is going to be 0 volts, both the transistor will not conduct. So there exists a distortion, there exists a dead band, and that dead band is going to be called as the crossover distortion for the input sine wave. That is, for both the transistors to conduct, a minimum amount of voltage of 0.7 volts should be required. So, if the input is going to be less than 0.7 volts, both the transistors will not conduct and the output will be zero. So, that portion is going to be called as the crossover distortion. So, here your crossover distortion in audio amplifier is going to give an unpleasant sound, which is a disadvantage there. So, here what we are going to do, we are going to see that your transfer characteristics here. So, initially when Vi is positive, that means that till 0.5 volts, your Q1 will not conduct. When Q1 is not conducting, when input goes beyond 0.5 volts, my Q1 transistor conducts. When Q1 transistor conducts, you are going to have your output voltage to be present. So, output voltage is going to be present. So, till how much it is going to be present is to the maximum it can have VCC minus the voltage across your collector emitter terminal. VCC minus VCE and saturation is going to be the maximum voltage your transistor can get when it is going to be in saturation condition. That is, during positive half cycle, when the input is going to be less than 0.5 volts, your transistor will not conduct. So, we are going to have the output voltage to be zero. Once my input voltage crosses 0.5 volts, your transistor Q1 is going to start conducting. When the transistor Q1 conducts, the transistor can enter into saturation when it reaches a maximum voltage of VCC minus your VCE and saturation there. So, here that means that the input voltage should be VCC minus VCEN saturation plus VBEN. If it is going to be till that stage, your output is going to be, once that voltage is reached at the input side, then my output is going to be at saturation. The transistor enters into saturation there. Similarly, during the negative half cycle, if my input is going to be minus, that is my negative voltage, if the input is less than minus 0.5 volts, my transistor QP will not conduct, that is PNP transistor will not conduct. So, in that case also my output voltage will be constant or zero. And when my negative voltage increases, so at one point after minus 0.5 voltage, my QP transistor conducts and Q1 doesn't conduct. When QP conducts, you are going to have your transistor to be conducting and you are going to have the output voltage to be present. That means slowly my transistor enters into saturation. When my transistor will enter into QP transistor will enter into saturation is when my input voltage is going to be minus VCC. If I write my equation, it is going to be minus VCC plus VECP saturation minus VEBP is going to be, when that voltage is going to be reached, my output is going to be at saturation, that is minus VCC plus VECP saturation there. So, here at this we are going to have the transistor to be saturated during the negative cycle, and here your Q1 transistor will be saturated during the positive cycle. So, this region from minus 0.5 to plus 0.5 is going to be called as the dead band. So, this dead band results in the crossover distortion. So, we will not be getting a proper output during this band. So, here in this case, you can see, illustrate the dead band in the class, illustrating the dead band in class B transfer characteristics. So, here in this, this is your input signal. My dead band is going to be here 0.5, here minus 0.5. During this period, when my input signal is going to be during this period, my output will not be present. So, as a result, my output is going to be zero there. Once my input crosses your 0.5 voltage, my output is going to conduct. So, I am going to have my output there. So, during the dead band, I am going to have a dead band here. That is the crossover distortion. My transistor will not be getting the output during that period, minus 0.5 to plus 0.5. So, that is going to be called as, this small line is indicates that it is your crossover distortion. So, this is going to be called as your crossover distortion. So, next is, we are going to see what is going to be the efficiency of your class B amplifier. So, in class A amplifier, we are seeing the efficiency to be 25%. Now, we are going to see what is going to be the efficiency of class B amplifier. So, we are going to neglect the crossover distortion and we are going to consider the output sinusoidal peak amplitude V0. So, the average load power, we know that your output is going to be the load power, input is going to be the signal power. So your efficiency is nothing but output by input. Output is nothing but PL, input is PS. So efficiency is equal to PL by PS. Now we want to find out PL. So neglecting the crossover distortion, we are going to consider the output sinusoidal waveform of peak amplitude V0. So the average load power will be PL is equal to half into V0 square by RL. So V square by RL, so in this case it is going to be your average load power for both the transistors. If I am going to take it, is going to be half of it, so it is half V0 square by RL. The current drawn from each supply is going to be consist of half sine waves of the peak amplitude. Your total amplitude is going to be V0 by 2RL. So in this case your current drawn is going to be half of the sine wave of the peak amplitude, that is V0 by RL. So the average current drawn from each of the two power supplies will be V0 by pi into RL. The average power drawn from each of the two power supplies will be same, because it is going to be both the transistors will be alternately conducting. So the average power that is going to be drawn by the two power supplies will be the same here. So PS plus is equal to PS minus input signal power is equal to 1 by pi V0 by RL into VCC. So the total supply power is nothing but addition of these two, that is PS is equal to 2 into V0 by pi RL into VCC. Now efficiency is nothing but PL by PS. PL is half into V0 square by RL divided by 2 V0 by pi RL into VCC. That is equal to, if I cancel, if you are going to see it, my output is going to be pi by 4 into V0 by VCC. If the output amplitude, the peak output amplitude, if I am going to neglect the VCE saturation and I am going to assume that your output is going to be VCC. We know that the output is nothing but VCC minus VCE saturation. So if I neglect VCE saturation, then my output I can approximate it to VCC. If I approximate it to VCC, eta is equal, efficiency is equal to pi by 4 into VCC by VCC. It gets cancelled, that is nothing but pi by 4. So the maximum efficiency is going to be 78.5. So if I compare with class A amplifier, in class A amplifier the efficiency is going to be only 25%, even though we get the full signal output, but in class B amplifier the efficiency has been increased to 78.5. So here in this case the maximum average power that is going to be available from class B output stage is obtained by substituting the obtained in the average load power equation. So that is, we have written that the PL is nothing but load power is half into V0 square by RL. We know that the maximum average power, if I want, the maximum voltage I can get at the output is VCC. So instead of V0, replace it by VCC. So PL max is equal to half into VCC square by RL. So this is about your class B power amplifier. So in the next video, we'll be seeing about class A B amplifier.